So today we are going to discuss the determination of pK value of given weak acid. So what is weak acid? So before we discuss what is weak acid, what is an acid? Acid is a substance when in solution donates its plus ions. We have two types of acids, strong acid and weak acid. What do you mean by strong acid? A substance when in a solution dissociates completely into respective ions is called a strong acid. A substance when in solution dissociates partially into respective ions is called as weak acid. Example for strong acid is HCl, HNO3. Weak acid is all organic acid. Strong acid all inorganic acid, weak acid all organic acids. So today let us determine the pK of a given weak acid. So pK can be determined only for weak acids and not for strong acids. So why? Let us see. So as I told you, strong acid dissociates completely into respective solution. So HCl dissociates to give H plus and Cl minus, whereas weak acids dissociates. For example, let us consider acetic acid CH3COOH. It will dissociate partially to give CH3COO minus and H plus. So in a weak acid, there is an equilibrium between reactants and products that is represented by K. Since it is an acid, it is represented by Ka, it is an acid dissociation constant. If it is a base, it is represented by Kp, it is base dissociation constant. This cannot be seen in your strong acid because it is a only forward reaction. There is no equilibrium. It dissociates completely, whereas weak acid dissociates partially. So hence, weak acid, we can determine pK only for strong acids and not for we can determine pK only for weak acids and not for strong acids. How to determine pK? We're going to take a solution, we're going to titrate it against the weak acid, we're going to take and titrate against NaOH. So at one run, measure the pH of the reaction. So pH will increase slowly, and at one particular point there is a sudden jump in pH. Once there is a sudden jump in pH, we're going to take 4 more readings and stop the experiment. So but here, when there is a sudden jump in pH, implies that we are going to find out the neutralization point. And how to determine? How to determine pKa? So what do you do is, according to Henderson equation, pH is equal to pKa plus concentration of salt by acid. So here, pH is equal to pKa only when concentration of salt and acid is equal to 1. When concentration of salt and acid is equal to 1, log 1 is equal to 0, pH is equal to pKa. So when is concentration of salt equals concentration of acid? Let us consider we are adding NaOH to an acid. So it gives you salt and water. So initially this concentration of acid is 100, salt is 0. We are adding 0.5 ml, this will become 90 and this will become 10. So when you substitute this 10 by 90, nothing, right? Here another 0.5 ml, 80, 20. So 20 by 80, so it is, you get some fraction. So at one point of time, what will happen? The concentration of acid and concentration of salt, both are equal. That is 50-50. So when you substitute 50 by 50, what will happen? It will become 1, log 1 is 0. That is when the reaction is half complete. 50-50 means reaction is half complete. Full means this will become 0, this will become 100. So in that time it is not possible. When the reaction is half complete, pH is equal to pKa, that is half equivalence point. So first we are supposed to determine the equivalence point, then determine the half equivalence point, later we are going to determine the pK of the solution, pK of the given weak acid. So pH is equal to pKa plus log concentration of salt by concentration of acid. So pH is equal to pKa plus log concentration of salt by concentration of acid. Okay, so now let us see how to perform the experiment. So in pure, we're going to take NaOH, beaker, take weak acid. We're going to dip the combined calomel glass electrode into the solution. Add NaOH in the increments of 0.5 ml. For every addition, we're going to measure the pH. Okay, so pH will increase slowly. So near the end point, there will be a sudden jump in pH. Later, there is slow increase in pH. So take 4 more readings when pH increases. Okay, then plot a graph of delta pH by delta V against volume of NaOH and determine the equivalence point. Later, plot another graph of pH against volume of NaOH and determine pH at half equivalence point. So this is delta pH by delta V versus volume of NaOH, and this is pH versus volume of NaOH. When you take pH versus volume of NaOH, this is half equivalence point. If the equivalence point is 5 ml, half equivalence point means 5 ml by 2.5. So at 2.5, you take at x-axis, draw a parallel line until it touches the curve. Once it touches the curve, draw a perpendicular line to y-axis. Whatever value you get here, that is pKa. So now we have a small demonstration on how to do the experiment. I'll just show you. The demo for the performing pKa experiment. Sorry.
The experiment determination of pH of human weak acid using glass electrode. So what is pH? pH is negative logarithm of which is ion. So here in order to determine the pH of a given weak acid, we are going to take the combined glass electrode, or we can use two electrodes to the sand cannon electrode combined with the ion cycle electrode glass electrode. These both electrodes are coupled and dipped in the weak acid whose pH is really double. This connected to the pH meter. So once you measure the pH, you are going to calculate delta pH, delta pH by delta. So let's calculate pH first. So I have taken 25 ml of weak acid, acetic acid here. So before adding any NaOH, the reading is around 3.1. So I am going to add any NaOH increments of 0.5 ml. Slowly. So we need to add in those increments of 0.5 ml, 0.5 ml, until there's a sudden jump. Once there's a sudden jump in which we're going to take 4 more readings and stop the experiment, we need to calculate delta pH, delta pH by delta V, and then plot the graph. So we'll see how to plot the graph later once we complete the readings. So, we have calculated the recommended pH of weak acid. So, around 5.0, there is a sudden jump in pH. Around 5.5, so we have got around 11.75. So, once there is a sudden jump in pH, we will take 4 more readings and stop the experiment and calculate delta pH and delta pH by delta. Once we get the delta pH to delta V, we are going to plot a graph of delta V to delta V versus volume of NaOH. So, from that, we will determine the neutralization point or equivalence point. So the nature of graph will be like this. So here, the equivalence point here is 5.0. So equivalence point was observed. We're going to plot delta V with delta V versus volume of NaOH. We have received equivalence point. From this, we're going to calculate half equivalence point. What is half equivalence point? Equivalence point by 2. So 5.0 by 2. We're going to plot another graph. The other graph is pH versus volume of NaOH. So you get a curve, S-type curve, at half equivalence point, pH is equal to pKa. So as per Henderson equation, pH is equal to pKa at half equivalence point is 2.5, going to draw a parallel line to y-axis until it touches the curve. Once it touches the curve, we're going to draw a parallel line to x-axis until it touches the y-axis. So whatever value you get here, that is pKa. So here, half equivalence is 2.5 and pKa is 4.6. This is how you are going to determine the pKa value of given weak acid. Thank you.
Got it right. This is how we are going to determine pKa of given weak acid. We are going to supposed to plot two graphs. First, delta pH by delta V versus volume of NaOH, determine equivalence point. Later, plot another graph, pH versus volume of NaOH and determine pKa. Thank you.